That check dam looks like it's right on schedule.
Yeah. You want to fly over the other location?
Sure do.
Know where you are, Lassie?
Don't think that she doesn't.
This map's about to become obsolete.
Well, if we can move mountains, changing a relief map can't be any big deal.
Let's fly over and check at Frank Driscoll's. Jeep sticks out like a sore thumb.
Good thing, too. It carries dynamite. The fourth hill we've climbed this morning, and it isn't even 9:30 yet.
You're a little out of shape, Joe.
Why can't your men blast on level ground?
We're building dams, not digging holes. You should get out of that flying egg beater and use your legs more like Lassie. Is everything okay?
Fine. We're setting the charges and hooking them up. We checked the roads and trails. They're all clear.
Well, that's good.
No, Frank. I wouldn't have your job. Working with dynamite day in and day out. Too much chance of blowing up.
Well, I'm too nervous to ride in your helicopter. Too much chance of falling down.
I guess Lassie and I must have complete faith in you two heroes. Otherwise, we wouldn't work with either one of you.
Hand me that blasting wire, Corey, will you? Thanks.
We gotta go back and check Sam Ellsworth's area.
I'll finish this up here, and then I'll get back to the control center. When the men are in, I'll fire the 10 o'clock blast.
See you later.
Hey, Joe!
These are going down. Fast as two. If you just let go, roll.
Girl, hard to believe that before too long we'll be swimming and fishing here.
It's got to be a pretty expensive swimming pool.
And power plant. Not to mention irrigation for all that barren land we've been flying over.
Yeah.
Let's go.
I glad to see you.
Something wrong, Sam?
There's something wrong with the drill. I can't find out what. But I can't go in for another one and get back in time for the 10 o'clock blast.
You fellas could do it easily.
Joe. Let me have that spare jackhammer, Charlie.
I'm sorry, Corey. I can't take any chances on weight. Lassie will have to stay here till we come back.
You're the pilot, Joe. Come on, Lassie. You stay here till I get back. You understand? It's a safety measure, girl.
Equipment.
Let's go watch him.
I don't know, Russ. You know how grown-ups are. One of them's going to ask, why aren't you kids in school?
We could tell them we're sick.
They'll know we're playing hooky as soon as they see us. Let's cut through the woods. She can come with us if she wants to. Let's get away from her, but don't run.
Thank you.
Thanks again, Corey.
You're welcome.
You gonna be able to get that dynamite hooked up and get back to the control center by 10 o'clock?
No problem, Corey. No problem.
Okay, Sam.
Let's take another swing over the area. Check the roads and trails. Be sure they're all clear.
Roger and up.
Glad to see me. All right, girl, I'm back. Lassie! She's heading for the blast area. Come on, let's take the chopper. Try to keep her in sight. Circle around. Put it down. I don't know what's the matter with her.
Part of it?
All right, part of it.
This whole area is going to blow up, and Lassie with it. If we don't find a place to set it down and catch you right now. There she is. Thank you.
what they're doing.
Grass of the kingdom come.
Take these kids and Lassie in the copter, Joe, and get them out of here.
I can't leave you here.
Won't carry all of us, remember?
I'll radio in and tell them to hold the blast.
Can't do that. Your radio transmission could set it off. I've got 2 minutes. I can disconnect the dynamite in that time if you don't waste any of it. Now get them out of here. Go, Joe, Lassie. To get to that wire.
Killed you. Come on, Lassie.
Come back for us. As I said a long, long hour ago, someday we'll be swimming and fishing here.